Glory, glory, glory. Ha, what a wonderful day the Lord has made. We rejoice and be glad in it. Happy new month to every one of you out there in the name of Jesus Christ. The month of March, where God will make you to go to favorable places, march to favorable places, and march upon every obstacle that will stop you this year in the name of Jesus Christ. I bring you greetings all the way from Athens, Greece, and from my wonderful husband, Teacher Smart Osaibo Akpata, General Overseer of God's Glorious Chapel International Gospel Ministry, is the Bishop of God's Glorious Chapel. And we give God all the praise for the power of God and the grace upon us, doing His wonders in the land of Europe in the name of Jesus Christ. Again and again and again, we are coming your way to tell you that this year you will testify. This year you will have victory in Jesus' name. And a part of this is what we are talking about every week. And I believe they have been a blessing to your life in Jesus' name. Last week we talked about that, what do you want? And today we are going to talk about that there are people in your life that will make you testify this year, that will make you have victory this year. Not everybody can be part of your testimony. Not everybody that can make you be successful this year. But I believe as we talk more, you will see that there are people that you need to make you successful in the name of Jesus Christ. There are two types of people here on earth, those that are positive and those that are negative. And I believe that before we finish, you will know what you want this year. And as many have been disappointed by people, you will regain your strength back again in the name of Jesus Christ. We go to the Bible, Mark 2:4-12. That story is all about four friends that helped their friends to become blessed again, to become successful again. Jesus Christ was preaching in Capernaum. A lot of people came to listen to him. The crowd was so much that nobody can get to him. And these four friends came, bringing their sick friends that was paralyzed. And they saw that if they don't go and do something fast, they may not be able to get their friend healed by Jesus Christ. They have to decide and they have to go to the roof. They have to destroy the roof and lay low this man that was sick, that could not walk. They lay him down and Jesus saw them and said, wow, what a great friends are these ones. How could they do such a great thing for their friends? Even though they destroyed the roof, Jesus Christ looked at them and said, oh, your sins are forgiven. But this thing you have done for your friends, by doing this favor thing for your friend will get his healing today. And Jesus Christ prayed for that man, and that man restored back his healing again, and everyone started praising God. So this year, you need favor people to be in your life, because four in the spiritual realm or the Bible tense represent favor. You ask God for favor people in your life, the people that will lift you up, the people that will not deceive you, the people that will not destroy you, the people that will not love you in your front and hate you at your back, the people that will not sell you out to your enemies, the people that will comfort you, the people that will criticize you in love and then still continue loving you, the people that will accept you the way you are, the people that will bless you, the people that will speak blessing into your life, no negative words, the people that will encourage you, not discourage you, the people that will be fruitful to you, the people that will make you serve God well, the people that will encourage you to do the right things, the people that will not take you to places that will make you to join things that will destroy you, that will not bring peace to your life, but the people that will you connect with, they will bring good ideas, they will not be intimidated by your success, they will not be intimidated at what God is doing in your life, but they will complement your life, they will help you to fulfill your destinies. These are the people you need in your life. And you ask me, how can I know these people? The only way you can know these people is by having the fear of the Lord. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of the wisdom of God, according to Proverbs 1:7. And you will have the Spirit of God, because it's the Spirit of the Lord that will lead you to every good things. If you don't have the Spirit of God leading you and you are using your emotion, you are leaning on your own understanding and not acknowledging the presence of the Lord in your life, you will end up meeting people that will frustrate your life. You will end up meeting the wrong people. But if you allow the Spirit of the Lord to lead you, my brothers and sisters, you pray and you don't let allow emotion, you don't allow things that will make you to see the outside of the person or not the fruit of the person, you will see that you will be meeting people that will help you. You'll be meeting the right people in the name of Jesus Christ. By the fruit you shall know them. Many of you are just, the enemy have closed your eyes not to know them. But by the special grace of God, today you will start knowing them as you connect yourself to our Lord Jesus Christ in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray for you today. I prophesy to you today, as many of you that have connected to the wrong people, that have been disappointed, that have been frustrated by people, by the prophecy of God through his word, that God has said that if you obey him, if you worship him in spirit and in truth, the blessings of the Lord will be upon you. Today, by the special grace of God, the Lord will open your eyes to know the right people. The Lord will send helpers to you that will help you, that will raise you up, that will make you to be successful in the name of Jesus Christ. I disconnect you from every forces of darkness, every unprofitable people that come to steal, to kill, to destroy you, by the authority in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name, you are free, and the helpers from God will come to your way in Jesus' name. Amen. And if you don't have Jesus Christ in your life, you will be hopeless. If you don't have Jesus Christ, your enemy will come to steal, to kill, to destroy you. But God has come to give you life in abundance. If you want that life, why don't you pray this prayer with me? I receive you as my Lord and personal Savior. I repent of my sins, and I'm saved, and I accept you into my life. Take control and help me in Jesus' name. Amen. Please, I want you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Like and like and like and share it. Drop a comment. And also like our page, Facebook page. Go to our website. Even go to our Google search and give us a 5 great star. And the Lord will bless you in the name of Jesus Christ. Follow us in our Instagram. We love you. We'll be coming your way next week to tell you that a principal man can conquer principalities. That if you are a principal man, principality cannot destroy you. Yeah, this year in the name of Jesus Christ. We bless. We love you. And Jesus loves you more. Next week, we see you. And come your way in Jesus' name. Amen.
For arms that lift us when we go.